In this lab, we will be connecting to Microsoft Azure Stack using PowerShell. The scenario is that we have deployed an actual Microsoft Azure Stack instance, and we would like to manage it using Azure PowerShell. After we have completed this exercise, you will know the steps that are involved in connecting to Microsoft Azure Stack admin endpoint using PowerShell. At a very high level, this is a four-step process which we will go through in this exercise. First thing that we need to do is install Azure Stack compatible PowerShell modules. Then we will download Azure Stack tools. Later, we will configure Azure Stack PowerShell environment. Last and the fourth step into the process is we will connect to Azure Stack instance using PowerShell. So let's get right into it. The first thing that we need to do is go ahead and log into the server. So in this case, I've already done that. And then go ahead and click on start. And then type PowerShell. So there is PowerShell ISE. Right click on that and select run as an administrator. In the interest of time, I have already opened up the PowerShell session here. And as you can see, there are multiple commandlets that we need to type during this lab environment. And there are a couple of ways we could deal with that. Either we can manually enter each one of them, which is what I generally do, or we can copy and paste these commandlets from the TechNet documentation. I will read off a few of these commands as we go through this video today. However, the suggestion would be to copy and paste these commands from the documentations available on the TechNet. As you could tell, these are long strings that are available. So the first task is install compatible Azure PowerShell module. And the first command that we are going to run is the PS repository. Just highlight this and click on run the selected command line. And what this will do is it actually configure a PowerShell gallery as a trusted repository for us to use later in the session. The second command is set the execution policy. Select that and click on run. So with this, what we have done is we have stored the current value of the Windows PowerShell execution policy in a variable. The third command would be to install Azure RM Bootstrapper modules. Select that and click on run. So this command will install Azure RM Bootstrapper module. This module is actually necessary for us to subsequently use the Azure Stack compatible Azure RM modules. So we will be doing that in just a minute from now. Go ahead and select the fourth command, which is use Azure RM profile. So we leverage the API version profile. So let's go ahead and run this command. And so one thing that you will notice here is in this commandlet is the date that you see there, right? So that's one thing to keep in mind, right? Of course, the date that we have in this command is 2018 March 1st. And that's the date related to the profile. It could change because there are plenty of updates as far as Azure Stack goes. It gets updated fairly quickly. So it'll continue to get updated. And so you need to use the current version for your own instance of Azure Stack. So make sure you check the latest version. For the purpose of our lab environment, we will go ahead and use the profile version of 2018, March 1st. This is up to date as of today. Now, the next command would be to go ahead and install module name Azure Stack. The required version is 1.5.0, which is an up-to-date version today. So this command will go ahead and install Azure specific PowerShell module, which we will need. And this include Azure Stack admin, Azure Stack storage. So let's go ahead and run the last command in our task one. So we'll run this command get module list available. where object name like Azure. So go ahead and run that command. So what this command will do is this will basically allow you to view all the newly installed Azure RM and Azure Stack modules. It takes a couple of seconds, and then you can see there's quite a bit of information that's available with respect to the modules that are installed on it. So now we have completed all the commands that are part of our task one. Now we will move on to the task two, where we will install the Azure Stack tools after we download them. And again, the recommendation would be to copy and paste these commands from the documentation on the TechNet. However, one thing that to keep in mind, right, when you copy commands from the TechNet, at the end of some of the lines, you will see there's a single backtick that indicates that it goes to the next line. So it's a continuous string. If you copy and paste, make sure that you delete that single backtick at the end of it. So the first command that we are going to run as part of our task two is set location path C colon backslash, and go ahead and hit enter. As you can see, the next command, it's a long string, and there are three more commands that we need to execute here. So I have already copied and pasted these commands here. So let me go ahead and select the second command, which is invoke web request, and hit enter. So what we are doing now is we are copying the archive that contain the GitHub repository that are hosting the Azure Stack tools onto a local server. And then the next command we will use is expand archive, select that and hit enter. So we expand that archive to C colon backslash Azure Stack tools masters, which is something that we will be revisiting later in this session. So go ahead and click the last command. So the tools contain the PowerShell module that offer broad range of features, including Azure Stack capabilities, Azure Stack VM infrastructure, image configuring resource manager policies, registering Azure and Azure Stack connectivity, the Azure Stack tenant management, as well as validation of Azure Stack resource manager templates. So with this, we have completed all the commands that are part of our task two. Now we'll move on to task three, where we configure Azure Stack PowerShell environment. So for that, we are going to run the first command, which is import module, select that, and then hit run. So this command basically goes ahead and import the modules and the connect module into the Azure Stack tools. And this is actually necessary in order for us to connect to the Azure Stack deployment later in the session today. Now let's also go ahead and run the second command, which is Azure RM environment. Select that and hit enter. So we have defined the ARM endpoint here. Select that and say run. So what we are doing here is we are registering an Azure RM environment that represents the admin endpoint for our Azure Stack deployment. Let's go ahead and do the same thing for our Azure Stack user. Hit enter. So once you enter this command, this will just register an Azure RM environment representing the tenant endpoint for our Azure Stack deployment. So we have completed step one, step two, and step three. Now let's move on to step four, the task four. We will now move on to the task four. And since our lab environment is using Azure Active Directory environment, so we will be running a couple of commands here. You will notice that there are two strings that we see for the tenant IDs. So I'm going to enter each of those because, like I mentioned, we are using Azure Active Directory. And then we'll move on to the next commands down in the PowerShell session. So let's select the first one. And this is for Azure Stack admin. And as you could also see, I have defined our Azure Active Directory tenant name here. Highlight this and then go ahead and click on run. And let's do that for our tenant as well. Go ahead and click on run. Now we have done this command. So step four is also completed. Now we are moving into our last part of this session, which is to connect to the Azure Stack endpoint. So what we are going to do now is connect to the Azure Stack endpoint, and we will connect to the admin endpoint specifically, and we will do that, of course, by using PowerShell. So as you could see, there are a couple of commandlets that we need to run. So let's go ahead and select the first one, which is we define the admin username and hit enter. Let's go ahead and run the second one, which is admin password, and this also convert to a secure string. So go ahead and hit enter. Let's go ahead and run the admin credential and go ahead and click run. So by doing this, we are generating PS credential objects that contain the encrypted credential of the admin user account. So we need to run this command. So now what we need to do is sign into our admin endpoint of our Azure Stack deployment. And in order to do that, we are going to select this command login Azure RM account environment and go ahead and run this command. So as you could see, there is a good amount of information available with respect to the account, the subscription name, that we have the subscription ID, we also have tenant ID, and then the environment is Azure Stack admin. Now we are connected to it. Now let's go ahead and create one resource group using our PowerShell session. So in this case, the resource group name is my resource group. So let me go ahead and validate that from the portal to see if a resource group with this name exists. So let's go to admin portal, refresh this, and I do not see my resource group. I see my resource group 1, but there's no my resource group. So let's go back to our PowerShell session, select this command, and go ahead and click on run. Now as we can see, the command completed successfully. So that means the resource group is now created. Let's go back to the portal and do validation. If I go ahead and click on refresh, there is my resource group has been created using the PowerShell session. So that concludes this lab. What we have done is we have been able to connect to our Azure Stack admin, our Azure Stack admin endpoint, and we have created a resource group. Thank you.